Welcome to Chiva IAS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. And for that purpose, we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, currently we have 12 series that focus on your prelims. So what we do in these prelims oriented series, we have basically divided your whole syllabus into 12 large subtopics. And what we do, we daily discuss two subtopics, and in this manner, in 6 days, we cover your all 12 subtopics. And this process goes on and on in a cyclic manner. And we will continue to do so till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC CSE 2019, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So let's start our discussion. The first question is, consider the following about the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. First, the scheme is functional only in rural areas. Second, the scheme targets below poverty line citizens only. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you friends that both of these are wrong. So the answer would be D, that is none. Solution is D. So friends, let's move on to the next question. Before moving to the next question, friends, let me tell you that if you want the explanation of these questions, you have to subscribe to the PDFs of these discussions, in which we provide the in detail explanation of why a particular option is correct and why others are incorrect, and in which context they will be correct. So in case you want to subscribe to the PDFs, you can contact us at this email ID, that is achievias21@gmail.com, or you can contact us at this number, that is 8968426481. So let's move on to the next question. Second question is, in a mixed economic system, A, only consumer goods are produced for sale in general market. B, profits are shared between government and capitalists. C, state-run enterprises are disinvested once they start making profits. D, both the government and the market together decide the economic production and distribution. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you friends that the answer is D, that is both government and market together decide what is to be produced and how it is to be distributed. So the solution is D. Now let's move on to the next question. Next question is, in India, foreign exchange reserves are managed by, this is a quite easy question, A, by the Reserve Bank of India, B, by the Government of India, C, jointly by the RBI and Scheduled Commercial Banks, D, jointly by RBI and International Monetary Fund. Let me tell you friends that the answer is RBI, Reserve Bank of India. So in India, foreign reserves are managed by Reserve Bank of India. Let's move on to the next question. Fourth question is, BharatNet project aims to, A, connect all households of India through broadband, B, strengthen existing e-governance portals in all panchayat offices, C, revive Sikh PSUs related to broadband and communication in India, D, link all institutions of higher learning by a common network. So let me tell you friends that the answer is A, that is, its aim is to connect all households of India through broadband. So the solution is A. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, microcredit programs are generally associated with, A, state loans to local bodies, B, trade cartels, C, self-help groups, D, scheduled commercial banks. So friends, let me tell you that microcredit programs are basically associated with self-help groups. So this is also a quite easy question. So the answer is C. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership does not propose to include which of these nations? So friends, this Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership is basically a free trade area agreement. It is proposed, and here we have been asked that which of the following countries is not part of it, proposed to be the part of it. A, Bangladesh, B, Thailand, C, Australia, A, D, India. Let me tell you friends that the answer is Bangladesh. So Bangladesh is not included in it. The solution is A. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, the term Navratnas is generally used for which of the following? First, group of scholars in the imperial court of King Vikramaditya and Akbar. Second, select group of public sector enterprises. Third, profit making central departmental enterprises. Fourth, group of kingdoms that occupied the northwestern province of India before the invasion of Ghazni. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you friends that only two statements are correct. That is first and second. That is, Navratnas were basically the scholars, nine scholars that were there in the court of Vikramaditya as well as in the court of Mughal Emperor Akbar. And also nowadays, public sector enterprises are categorized as Navratnas based upon certain criteria. If they meet it, they are declared Navratnas. So the answer is 1 and 2 only. So the answer would be D. That is 1 and 2 only. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, which of these can be categorized as capital goods industries? First, engineering goods. Second, textiles. Third, financial services industry. Fourth, construction and mining equipment industry. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you, friends, that the capital goods industries are engineering goods and the construction and mining equipment industry. So the answer would be 1 and 4 only. So what are capital goods industries? That thing is provided in our explanation PDF. So the answer is A. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, GDP is often calculated based on value added method. What do you understand by difference by the term value added? A, difference in the costs of input and output. B, difference in market price and subsidized price. C, difference in export price and import parity price. D, difference between earnings and taxes on the product. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is A. That is difference in the costs of input and output. It is called value added. So solution is A. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, what is often referred to as the balance of payment crisis is actually A, potential national default on its external obligations. B, a situation when government is unable to finance its fiscal deficit. C, a high percentage of revenue expenditure in the government budget. D, a zero account deficit. Let me tell you, friends, that the answer is a potential national default on its external obligations. So the answer would be A. So this is all about, friends, today's questions. If you like the questions, if you like the video, then do hit a like, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And lastly, friends, let me tell you that if you want to subscribe to the PDFs of these explanation if you want to subscribe to the explanation PDFs of these lectures, you can contact us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or at this number, that is 8968426481. So this is our official number that is linked with our channel Achieve IES. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. Thank you. Have a very nice day. Thank you very much.